Howdy, y'all. Mr. CAUSEY coming to you from beautiful Atascocita, Texas. And today we're going to look at net ionic equations. In this lesson, we're going to talk about total ionic equations. We're going to take a look at spectator ions and write a net ionic equation. You must know the periodic table, oxidation numbers, how to write equations, how to balance equations, and your solubility rules. And if you don't know any of these, be sure to go to my YouTube channel and check out the lessons that you aren't totally up on yet. And you will need a periodic table. You will need a polyatomic ion chart. And if you don't have one of these, go to this link right here. Pick up your free polyatomic ion chart. On the back of it, it has a lot of other great stuff, such as your solubility rules and your reactivity scale. All right, the basic steps: 1, write a balanced equation. 2, write a total ionic equation. Then remove the spectator ions and rewrite the equation. And that will be your net ionic equation. So what is a total ionic equation? It is a chemical equation that shows all the ions in a reaction, such as taking this reaction right here, which is just a common neutralization reaction. We know that sodium hydroxide and hydrochloric acid will dissociate and ionize. What are spectator ions? The ions in a chemical reaction that are unchanged. So if we go back and look at our total ionic equation, note that sodium and chlorine are unchanged. Therefore, they are spectator ions. And then we write a net ionic equation, which is a chemical equation that shows all the ions that change, but it ignores those that don't change, or the spectator ions, as they're called. And so here's our reaction again. We know that sodium is a spectator ion, and we know that chlorine is a spectator ion, so we'll cancel those out and rewrite the equation. There's our net ionic equation. So let's look at an example. A bar of zinc metal is immersed in a solution of copper 2 sulfate. And the first thing I want to do is go to my reactivity table and make sure that zinc will be more reactive than copper, and it is. So they are going to change places. Zinc is greater than copper. And so let's go to the board and write that equation out. So we have zinc solid and copper 2 sulfate aqueous, and that's going to give us zinc sulfate in aqueous solution and copper solid. And that's already balanced, and it's a single replacement reaction. Now, copper 2 sulfate and zinc sulfate are both soluble. I'm just going to check my solubility rules. And yes, note that all sulfates are soluble except for a few, and both copper sulfate and zinc sulfate are soluble. So they will dissociate, and we will get copper and sulfate ions, and we will get zinc and sulfate ions. So let's rewrite that now. Here's our whole total ionic equation. And note that we have some spectator ions. Sulfate is going to be canceled out, and then we can rewrite that. And there's our net ionic equation. All right, if you're not sure what happened there, be sure to go back and rewatch this and then practice some equations of your own. Let's review. You wrote a balanced equation, then you wrote a total ionic equation, remove the spectator ions, and you got a net ionic equation. If you have any questions, send an email to MrCAUSEY@MrCAUSEY.com. And don't forget to check out MrCAUSEY.com for more videos and handouts. It's growing every day. And subscribe to my YouTube channel. Happy ions, y'all.